ESPN, presented by Toyota.
All right, welcome back to the show here in Nacio. We want to welcome in 10-year NBA vet Ryan Hollins.
All right.
Ryan Hollins. He's also part of the Two Phone Club. What's up,
wait,
Ryan Hollins?
Wait, what is that? There you go.
That's
does this count as a phone?
I mean, maybe. I guess you could FaceTime on it, so that works.
This is like a little iPad in itself. But
exactly. Yeah, there you go. There you go.
All right, Ryan, we're doing a new game here on the show, a new segment. It's called Am I Loco? Okay, we ask Vato Loco some questions, and we'll answer if he's crazy or not. It's very simple.
Okay.
How we do this game. All right, let's go. What do we got? Here's the top five presented by Corona. Vato Loco.
Loco. All right, guys, this is the first one. Am I loco to think that Kyrie and LeBron can work it out?
All right, so we all know about the drama of Kyrie demanding a trade. Now, with all the damage done, is there a way of ironing the issues? Ryan, am I loco to think that Kyrie and LeBron can work it out and become BFFs again?
You're absolutely crazy.
Am I?
Because you're making a case saying that there's a problem. Who said that they have a problem with each other? Nobody said that. Kyrie is making a business move right now. He's thinking about his family. He's thinking about his future. And he sees LeBron is getting ready to leave. LeBron's going to make a business move. And Kyrie is going to make the same type of move. He's just a step ahead of LeBron right now. But as far as them actually having personal problems, beef on the court, that's us saying it. That's the fans. That's everyone else. We don't actually know that they have a problem.
Well, I'm going to tell you that I think they do have a problem. And I know enough people within the organization who have been in and out of that organization or who cover that team for a living that will tell you a couple of things. For example, when Kyrie and LeBron first got together, you know, Kyrie had just signed that big deal, right?
Yeah.
So LeBron came there a couple of weeks later. Kyrie thought that was going to be his team. For the first few months that they were even on the same team, they didn't even have their phone numbers, their cell phone numbers.
But wouldn't that be a problem with the organization and not each other?
Nah, it's an issue. And
hey,
he also, there was also talk about LeBron wanting to trade for Chris Paul. Who do you think they were going to trade for Chris Paul?
Kyrie? Let me ask you this.
He's in his feelings a little bit.
Let me ask you this. If we work together for a while, right? And you know that I want to move on to a different show. George, I don't want to do this anymore. But in the end, I'll be back. Would you look at me with the same eyes knowing that I wanted to leave?
Absolutely not. The hell with you.
That's a little issue. At least it's a little issue.
If you knew that it was a business move, if you're betting yourself or your family, who said that Russell and KD have problems? We make these scenarios just because guys aren't BFFs. NBA players are very private about how they feel, how they think, and how things go along. So that we assume just because a guy moves on, it's business. We can't forget it's business, fellas.
Oh, it is business. I'll give you that. But I think there's issues there personally, too. But ultimately, I agree. Bato's loco, they're not staying together. I think at this point, they're moving on.
That.
What's next?
Bato loco.
Am I loco to think that LaVar Ball is great for basketball, guys?
All right, so this one is a LaVar and his son LaMelo packed a Las Vegas arena alongside Zion Williamson. NBA stars were onside. Hall of Fame coaches and recruiters. The tip-off got delayed, and fire marshals almost canceled the event due to overcrowding. Crazy environment in the small arena. Speaking of crazy, Jorge, am I loco to think that LaVar Ball is great for basketball?
You're not local.
Oh,
he is great for basketball. He's the best thing that's happened to basketball in a long, long time. You know why? Because he gets the entertainment aspect of this.
The best thing that happened to basketball. Are you local?
I am not local. Let me explain this. He's crazy, crazy like a fox, because he's smart. Do you want to know this? The Lakers people told me this. They're getting the type of hits they're getting for any Lonzo post on Lakers.com.
Only
compares to Kobe's farewell season.
Ooh.
That's the type of stuff LaVar's brought to the table, because it ain't Lonzo's personality that brought this
out,
to the
amigo.
Table.
Help me out, please.
I want to help you, but you're local right now. He's great for basketball.
Oh my
he
God.
Has three sons that
real?
Made it to the best alma mater on earth. UCLA.
Oh, that's true. UCLA.
Okay.
Oh.
You get it.
I see where you're coming from now. All right,
He just sold out Summer League. We set Summer League records.
Never happened.
How much did you talk about Summer League?
All week long. Because of who?
Because of Lonzo and LaVar.
Well, because of Lonzo.
And LaVar.
Not because of LaVar. Okay, come NBA time. Come NBA regular season. Who are we going to talk of more? LaVar or his son, who's actually playing, who's actually going to handle the ball, taking shots, sometimes missing a lot of shots? Who's the most important guy right here? It's the player, not the dad.
Oh, look, on the court, it'll be Lonzo. And Lonzo's the reason the Lakers are going to be good again, because his style of play will attract great players, and we'll see that next offseason.
Amen.
But
Amen.
LeVar is always going to be in the news, whether you like it or not.
You know this is the NBA, not the WWE, right?
No, it's both now.
Oh, it's both. And listen, like I talked about earlier, the business of basketball, fellas. LeVar understands business. And when he steps into a team, when he steps into social media, when he gets behind the microphone, people want to listen. People want to go to Lakers games. Laker Nation is revitalized right now because of Lonzo, but more importantly, LeVar Ball.
It's annoying, like I said.
All right, what's next?
Okay, guys, am I loco to think that ejections are good for baseball?
Last night in the Nationals game, Bryce Harper went at it with an umpire over a bad call and got ejected. On the same night in a blowout game between the Rangers and Marlins, Adrian Beltre got ejected because he moved the on-deck circle. Look at this. He told him he's got to get in the circle. He then moved it. That's funny, right?
No humor right there.
No sense of humor by the umpire. So am I loco to think ejections are good for baseball, Mal?
No, you're not loco. Ejections are good for baseball.
What?
I love ejections. Yeah.
What?
This is fun.
Yes.
I mean, the ump said, step on the circle. What do you do? He actually took a step into the circle. He had to move the circle a little bit, but it's part of the game.
And it's funny.
I love when managers just go face to face with the umpire, when they throw dirt on home plate and take the bases and then go to the dugout. This is fun. It's part of the game. It's always been a part of the game. And it's harmless. What if I yell to the umpire a little bit? It's no problem. It's awesome to have that in baseball.
Ryan? Mauricio. Why do we watch baseball? We watch it to watch the players do what they do best. And when the referee ejects a guy over something as silly as this, the fans don't get what they want. Now we're entertained.
We see him yelling and screaming. The screams and yells, and he's not even a player. He's good for basketball.
But we want to see players
Why
play.
Why is he not good for baseball? It's the same thing.
Okay, I'll settle this real quick. You get 162 games. Baseball is generally considered boring, right?
Absolutely.
And you know what? Every once in a while, it's nice to get some action on the field. So I'm in on all that.
George,
I grew up watching Billy Martin and the Yankees as a little kid, and nobody did that theater better than him.
It's hard to show emotions on a baseball game, right?
Yes.
It's hard to show emotions. This is the only place when you can actually show how upset are you, how happy are you, or how much you want to punch an umpire in the face.
I believe there's a healthy way that players can express themselves, be who they are, have fun in games without being kicked out of the game. Maybe it was a funny interchange.
Have you ever been ejected?
It happens and you move on.
Have you ever been ejected?
And the fans loved it.
There you go.
By the way, that umpire with Beltre, zero sense of humor.
Oh my God.
What's next, Vado Loco?
Guys, am I loco to think that McGregor has a shot versus Mayweather?
All right, we're now less than a month away from Mayweather versus McGregor, and the odds of the fight have reduced more and more every day. In November, the odds of Mayweather winning were -2250. Now, it's only -500. Better odds than Andre Berto or even Marcos Maidana. Our friend Joe Cortez seems to like McGregor's odds. Let's listen in.
Viendo la preparación de McGregor, ahora estoy viendo que sí, muchacho tiene talento y tiene tremenda pegada. Ya he hecho sparring con boxeadores profesionales y veo que lo sorprende bastante bien, le conectas bien y digo, este muchacho puede sorprender a Mayweather esa noche también.
All right, am I loco to think McGregor actually has a shot here?
You know what? 2 weeks ago, I would have said you're loco. A year ago, I would have said you're loco. And I think about it like this, George. This is me and you playing one-on-one. Mm. I check the ball at half court, and you chuck up a three-pointer that goes in.
Right.
And you essentially beat me in a game of one-on-one. Mm-hmm. That's that one punch from Conor McGregor. Floyd Mayweather has everything to lose, like our one-on-one game.
Yeah. No doubt.
Right?
Yeah, I'm with you wholeheartedly. Now, look. I do think that Conor McGregor's at a huge disadvantage here. I think I'm loco, or the vato is loco in this case, because...
No, you're loco as well.
Because Mayweather, that's true, Mayweather is the best defensive boxer maybe in the history
of the sport.
Of course
he is,
absolutely.
Yeah.
Max Kellerman said on First Take a couple of months ago, he doesn't think that Conor McGregor will land one clean shot.
And I agree.
I'm more in the camp of Max Kellerman than I would be him actually winning this fight, even if it's a lucky punch.
Yeah, you are, I mean, that's absolutely madness. Muy, muy loco. Completamente loco. And I love Joe Cortez.
Yes.
That's mi amigo Joe Cortez.
Yes.
He's training with Conor McGregor.
Right.
Conor McGregor.
What the hell else is he
going
to say?
Conor McGregor, I guess, is paying Joker just a little coin. Of course he's going to say that. He's not going to go, you know, guys, I was just in Conor McGregor's training camp, and he has no shot whatsoever.
Right. True.
And you know how lines move in Vegas.
Yeah.
It's all about the money. And Irish people are not about betting on boxing. So they're probably putting a lot of dollars on Conor. And that's why the lines are moving like that.
Well, the lines are moving so much that I may just throw a bet on Mayweather at this point.
Yes, that's not a bad idea.
It's actually a smart bet on Mayweather because the lines move down so much.
All right.
All right, what do we got?
All right.
Am I loco to think that Ric Flair is the best wrestler of all time? Woo!
ESPN has released the newest trailer for The Nature Boy, a film about Ric Flair. The 30 for 30 will air on November 7th, but many people believe that The Nature Boy is the best wrestler of all time. Ryan, am I loco to think The Nature Boy is the best of all time, the GOAT?
Woo! You know what? I grew up a Hogan fan. And Hogan has had some PR issues with me. Hogan, just to say, it's had me.
What do you mean by PR issues?
Hogan has lost me. And when we talk about wrestling early, is this wrestling? Ric Flair is one of the best trash talkers of all time. And when you watch his interviews, he's a legend, and he's still spreading that legacy on. You still see him in wrestling. He comes to basketball events. He shakes your hand. I remember I got to live out my childhood fantasy in Memphis, sitting front row. Ric Flair walked by and gives Ryan Hollins one of those, woo, and I'll never forget it. Ric Flair, you're the best.
First of all, yes, the answer is yes, you are loco.
What?
Completamente loco.
What?
I'm not even going to get into comparing WWE with Lucha Libre Mexicana, Mexican wrestling luchadores, because I would bring Perro Aguayo to the table. I would bring El Santo to the table.
Ooh.
And Ric Flair, I'm sorry, Mr. Woo! You got nothing to do against El Santo or El Hijo del Santo for that.
See, here's the thing. You're talking about Mexican wrestlers who are unbelievable technical wrestlers.
Yeah.
And that's not necessarily what wrestling is all about. Wrestling, as we talked about earlier with LeVar Ball, is about the entertainment.
Woo!
So Ric Flair is Mr. Entertainment. He's entertainment personified.
Yeah.
And by the way, there would be no Rock. There would be no Stone Cold Steve Austin. All the Attitude Era in the WWE and the WCW, none of that would have happened had it not been for Ric Flair being the pioneer.
I would throw another name.
Ooh.
The Undertaker. With a different attitude, a different personality. But in terms of what the WWE was looking for, he was a great, great wrestler. I mean, he went like 20-0 in WrestleMania,
yeah.
The Undertaker.
And then he lost.
Of course he lost.
Watched for the answer.
The Undertaker's kind of boring. Sorry.
No. Yeah.
No chance. The Undertaker might be the most overrated wrestler ever, in my opinion.
God, are you for real?
Yeah, I'm sure. Him and Hogan, too,
best
for that matter.
Entrance, by the way. Best entrance.
Entrance are good.
Best walk-off.
Yeah, the skit was fun, but actually, like, he never actually said anything interesting.
He didn't have to.
Give me flair.
He didn't have to.
Give me the guys with flair. Like Ric Flair, like the Nature Boy.
Hey guys, I'm sorry. It's not real. You know that, right?
No, yeah.
It's not real.
Yeah.
It wasn't real. Wrestling's not real.
They're
not really fighting.
Wait,
it's scripted.
Whoa.
No, it's not real.
Yeah.
The guy who wins doesn't really win. It's a trash talk.
That is local.
Yes.
That is local, what you just said.
Ryan Hollins, ladies and gentlemen.
Right, that was fun.
Thanks for stopping by, my man. Great seeing you.
Ciao, amici.
All right, John Jones returns this Saturday to the UFC, and we have him right here in studio, so don't go anywhere.